You started as a musician, Evan, and then you've now, you had some success there, a top 20 single, which not a lot of folks can say, right? And you've left that career behind, and then you decided to become a businessman. I've always noticed that it's kind of rare when you get the creative mind and a business mind in the same body. Talk about that transition from musician and the dream of a musician and now starting a website to help musicians.
Well, I think to a certain degree that every artist actually is kind of an entrepreneur to a certain degree, even if they don't recognize it. I think that any band that you start is really a startup. You know, you have to create something from nothing. You have to market it, even if you don't believe in marketing it. If you want to be super cred and not do it, that's a marketing ploy in and of itself. Like, we're not going to go this route. Every night you have to put the put your sort of company together, your product together, put it on stage, keep the bandmates together. I mean, there's a lot of work that goes into it. You know, being in a band and really getting a business out of it is very entrepreneurial. My brother and I actually created our own record label in 94. So I think that we always saw there's a need to sort of create a business around some of the stuff we were doing. Not that we sought to be businessmen. Mm. I just think it was sort of a natural way or something we had to do in order to get to our fans. And so I was always fascinated as well. We had a website in 95. I've always been fascinated with finding ways to connect with my fans online, whether that was message boards or chat rooms early on. And then as it became, you know, with the advent of social media, finding a way to do that as well. So I think that for me, I'm not here as the CEO of Panasonic. Mm-hmm. I'm here as the CEO of a company that fuses together my sort of geek side, my love of technology, and using that to find ways to connect with my fans. And as an artist looking to connect with his fans around the world, those few remaining fans that I may have, there had to be a way to sort of connect with them. And so I went out and I was looking online to find a way to do that. And I didn't really see exactly what I felt was what I needed. So I created this out of a need. It wasn't sort of like, I didn't say, hey, there's a real big business opportunity here and I'm gonna do this and that. I really wanted to use technology to do what I felt would find a way to connect with my fans. And video broadcasting has been on the internet for over 15 years. But how could I do that in a way that wouldn't hurt my relationship with my fans and actually bring back a sense of mystery and romance?
You know, it's one thing to write some songs with a band and do all that. It's another whole animal to talk about building a business from scratch. Talk about, now you got your business hat on. Sure. You got this idea. I had an idea out in my backyard 2 years ago. And, you know, I bet you're a little past 10 grand and a few gray hairs along the way. Talk about that.
I remember being on the tour bus back in the day. I have a notebook of like inventions and everyone's got their own thing. And for me, I have this deep desire to constantly be creative. I sold a screenplay to New Line Cinema back in the day when I was recording my follow-up record. It was the first screenplay I ever wrote, and I didn't realize all of a sudden I'm on the cover of a Variety and Hollywood Reporter as a guy that, like, you know, is entering. And I was just like, wait, I was just writing a screenplay, having fun. It was a creative pursuit. I was doing it while I was traveling on the road. And so I've always felt this need. I actually was on this show called American Inventor, and I did it because I was executive producing a show on Fox, and that producer went over and created a show, and she's like, look, I know you always have these ideas. Can you just come on the show and present one of these inventions? So I feel like I've constantly have this need to sort of create. And I look at stage, it was an opportunity in terms of for the artist, not necessarily a business opportunity, but putting my business hat on. As I started to build it, I started going, wait a second, this is bigger, and I think a lot of artists could benefit from it. But I think that I was just dumb enough to give this a leap to do it. Probably the same way you were when you said, this is going to be $10,000 to $12,000. I'll have this thing up and running in 2 to 3 months, and we'll be good to go.
Yeah.
And if I knew, I mean, I told my friends and family when I started this, I said, listen, I'm not going to talk to you guys it's going to take me 6 months to get this company to where it needs to get to. Mm. 3.5 years later, and $2.5 million later, and a lot more than I would be happy with just gray hairs. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Stress. It's ruined my life. I have zero social life. Just everything. I've changed. I mean, this is a different conversation, but it has cost me.
You're welcome
dearly
to come back on season three.
I'll be laying on the couch this way.
Yeah,
that's what it's going to take.
There's a picture we have on our Instagram of me laying on the couch one night going, what the fuck was I thinking about?
Yeah.
Well, it's, it's one of the same kind of thing we go through with the band, frankly,
100%.
Right? 100%. But less people to share it with, it sounds like.